Once again, I am back. Myself, Kishore Chaudhary, and I am working as a developer in the Cloud World Technologies, and I am a C-Sharp Corner author too. So, in the previous articles, I have discussed about the concept of creating a free Azure trial account, in which you will be getting a credit of 13,300 Indian rupees. So there you would have seen the method of creating it, and I hope that you have already created it. If not, you just go to the previous video and watch it and learn to create it and just create a new account. So once you create it, then it's yours. You can use it for 1 month. Now in this article, I am going to speak about the concept of creating something called a storage account, that is a storage account in the Microsoft Azure portal, and uploading some data into there, as well as mapping that storage account to our network drive in the local computer. So for this, you should have an Azure subscription. First one is this, and the second one, you would have a good bandwidth internet. So that is the major thing when you do this, because when you are trying to upload something into the cloud, you need a good bandwidth. So before we get in, let me say you clearly. So a storage account is something which will be created in the Microsoft Azure. This Azure account is entirely different from storage account. The Azure account, it will be helping you to create a storage account inside it. So this storage account will help you to store different types of storage contents like blobs, queues, tables, and one more thing as file. So now we are going to make use of this file, because in a blob you can upload only up to data only up to a size of 4 MB. But when you go for this, when you go for this file share, you can store data for GBs and more than that, so you will be charged accordingly. So now let us see the concept. So for that, you need to open your browser. So I'm using this Chrome. So go for portal. Portal.azure.com. So it comes here. So when I click on this, it will be getting loaded, and it will direct me to my Azure portal. So this is the continuation of my previous video, right? So in there, I have created the Azure account and I have logged in. So again, I'm getting logged into the same account here. Once you create an account and log in, then there is no need for you to log in again and again unless you sign out. So see, look at here. So just now I created the account. Now I am having a credit of 13,300 Indian rupees. So I can make use of this credit and I can work with the Microsoft Azure environment. So first we have to create a storage account. Remember to use some storage capacity in my Microsoft Azure in the form of some container or blobs or file share. The first thing you should do is to create a storage account. So for that, click on new and you'll be getting all these things. In this, go for storage. So when you go for storage, see here, the storage account. So in this you can find blobs, tables, queues, and file shares for reliable and economical cloud storage. So here we're going to store things. So click on this one. This will lead you to create the storage account. There you should give some sort of name for your storage account. So remember, the storage account name which you are giving, it must be unique, because the storage account, it is not about your Microsoft Azure account alone. It will be helping you to access it from the applications which you create. So don't forget, you should give an unique name for your storage account. So here I am giving something as Windroid 002. I'm sure this will be a unique one. Yes, this is unique. So just look at this. This is the domain. So whenever you create something in this one, that is, what is this? When you create something in the storage account, whenever you create something in the Azure, for different services, you will be getting different sort of domains. When you go for a VM, it will be a different domain. So when you go for Azure mobile services, it will be different. When you go for web services, it will be different. So here for this storage account, you will be getting a domain as .co.windows.net. So make clear that you have different, unique name. So just select this one. So resource manager, you just leave it. You can go for a classic, or you can even go for this resource manager. I am keeping the same thing, resource manager. I'm not going to change anything. So here we have two things: account purpose, that is general, or blob. So blob, I have already told, in blob you can store up to 4 MB of data alone. So I'm using as general. So here standard and premium. I don't want to spend much of my much of my amount, so I'm going for standard itself. So here there we get four types of redundancies. So zone redundancy, local, geo redundancy, and read access. So when you go for zone redundancy, so consider that there is a data center in central India. So when you store some sort of data in the concept of zone redundancy, your data will be get stored in three different hard disks in three different zones. Hard disks in the same zone. Consider that it is in some place in Delhi. So in that place, inside the same data center, it will be stored in three different parts. So that is called as zone redundancy. So now when you come for local redundancy, it will be say present in the same rack. That is, the hard disk will be present in the same rack, but the data which you store will be stored in three hard disks, but all the three will be in the same rack. And the third one is geo redundancy. This is what a secured one, because in this concept, your data will be stored in three different locations in three different data centers. Clear? That is, your data will be stored in the form of primary data and secondary data. The primary data will be the thing which will be accessing, and the secondary data, it will be acting as a backup for your data. So this will be located in different locations, not in a single location. It will be located in some other locations, like consider this, one will be in central India, one will be in Southeast Asia, and one will be in the Australian data center. So this is how the things happen. So I am selecting the local redundant because I don't want to spend much. So here, storage service encryption. This is for some sort of security purpose. I'm not going to touch it. Let it be the same. So here, and I go for trial purposes. Already once I have used the DreamSpark, and that one will be valuable for only 1 month. So right now I'm not going to use it. I'm going for the trial. So this makes me to make use of this. Subscription will make me to make use of the storage account. Now, the next thing is I have to select the resource group. A resource group is something which will help you to organize the things which you have created. So consider this, you have created some storage account, some virtual machines and some web services and IoT console, IoT hub and etc. So if all these are in the same display, you cannot find which one is the thing which you actually need. So for this purpose, you are using something called resource manager group. So this resource group, it will help you to organize things separately. So if I click on this one, I'll be shown some existing groups, but there are no groups already created. So I'm clicking on create new one. I'm giving as Windroid videos. Yeah, Windroid videos. The reason I give this because this must be linking to our channel. So now a group is created, that is a resource group, that is a Windroid videos, and under this video, Windroid videos, you'll be hitting the storage account. Now finally, I have to select my location. Since I am in India, I'm going to choose Central India. Where it is? So Central India, yeah, here it is. So I selected Central India, and finally I can choose to, pin to dashboard, or if I leave it, doesn't matter, it will get created. So I'm clicking on create. So this will take a small amount of time based on the loading the server as well as the speed of our bandwidth. But doesn't matter, when you click on, once it gets hitted in the server, for sure it will get created. It's not based on your bandwidth, but see, it's over. So the server load is not much, so it got created. So it's getting initialized. This deployment getting initialized. Maybe this will take a small amount of time. So I'll pause the video and I'll come back once it gets deployed. Yeah, here we go. I've resumed it. Now we can look at this deployment succeeded. So now we have successfully created the storage account. Now the next one is to create a container in the storage account. So first, to check the storage account which you created, click on the resource groups. This will load the resource groups which you have created. So previously you have created something called Windroid. So here it is, Windroid videos. So click on this one. So here you can find the things which you have created. So I have created something, storage account called Windroid. This is the storage account. You can add something from here. If you click on this add, the things which you are going to, either a virtual machine or something which you are going to create, it will get added to this cloud, this resource group. So now I'm clicking on this Windroid.node2. So let us check what are there in this one. Give me a moment, it'll get loaded. So now just look at this one. You have when you go for this WinRoid Nortonware 2, you can find this blobs, files, tables and queues. So these are the four different type of storages which can be used in this one. So you can make use of this. So now I'm not going to speak about these blobs, tables or queues. At present I'm going to speak about this one, the files. So here I'm going to make use of this files concept, and I'm going to create a file share where you can store your data and at the same time you can retrieve your data. So here, when you create this file share, you have two options. Number one, you can upload the data into a file share, and number two, you can do that either from the Azure portal or you can even do that from your local machine, that is in the my computer. So first I'll show the concept of creating that file share. So click on this one. So this will redirect you to this creation of this file share concept. So here you can find something called file share. So this is the thing which you are going to create in which you are going to store something. So click on this. This will be same as the things which you create. Okay. So here I have to give some name. So the same thing, sample share, or simple share. Yeah, I should not use caps, I think. Yes, let us see. Yeah, file share cannot contain lowercase uppercase. Yes, we should not have spaces and numbers. So simplesvac. So I give, it is considered now. So here you can have the data only in GBs, not in MBs. Okay, so the minimum data you can have is 1 GB, or you can give it in the sort of 0.52512 or etc. But I have never tried it. Let it be in the GBs itself. So the minimum data will be 1 GB. So I am using 1 GB. Or in some other case, you can use the data. I mean, use the amount of size you can. So I am using 1 GB and I am clicking on create. So let this get created. So yeah, it is successfully created. Now something called simple space. I have made a spelling mistake. It's okay. So something has been created in the form of file share. Now just click on this. So it is loading. So here, this is where you're going to upload your files. Whenever you upload something into your file share, it will be found in this location. Okay, so now they just look on these menus. The first one is connect. This will help you to connect your device, that is your Azure portal and your machine, first thing. And the second one, you can directly upload your files right from this location. And the third one, add directory. So a directory is nothing but a folder, right? You know that. If you don't, just listen, understand this. A directory is nothing but a folder. So if you click on this, it will ask you to give some sort of name, and if you give the name, a directory will get created in here. So we shall do that later on. So the next one is refresh. Though sometimes when you upload something, it will not be visible in this location. So for that purpose, when you click on refresh, it will refresh and bring back those things. The next one is delete share. When you click on this option, the simple space, whatever this is, so this will get deleted. And finally, the properties. So the properties will be having some sort of URLs through which you can access. So this is the URL. So using this, you can access your file share. And the quota, this quota will be showing the amount of data you have already been rendered for this share service. And at the same time, you can change it. So finally, first thing, uploading. So the easiest way is coming to the Azure portal and uploading. But there is one more easiest way, but we shall discuss about it in the next step. But before that, I have to save something. Basically, while the new portal of the Azure was being created, at that time there was no option for us to upload things directly from the Azure portal. At the time we want to use the PowerShells, and in the PowerShell we were asked to write the PowerShell commands. So don't worry about it. Here now we are not having such a problem. We can make use of this upload button, or we can use this upload button and we can directly upload things in here. So before you do that, make sure that you're going to upload something. So you should have already created it. So I'm going to my desktop. Here desktop will be not visible for you. So I'm going to my PC. In my PC, I'm going to this PC option, and here in the new volume, I'm going to create something called a text document. A text document name is my file share. So I have created it. Now I'm going to open it, and in here, this is a shared file. Okay, now let us finish it and let me save this one. So I have closed it. Now I'm going to upload this file to the file share. So to do that, I'm coming back to the Azure portal. So I'm clicking on the button upload. So when I click on this, see here, I have to choose the file which I'm going to upload. So here to upload this one, click on this. So this is asking to browse the file which is in your local computer. So the same thing, I'm going to the new volume. There I have created a file called my file share. So I'm clicking on open. So the file has been selected in here. Now if I click on upload, the file will get uploaded. See, it's of size 24 bytes and it has been already uploaded. So in this concept, you can upload your files again and again and again. So this is the concept number one. So here, if you click on this one, you'll get the options for this. And when you click on the download button, this will show you the details which are in the file. So see here, it is getting downloaded. So when you open this, yeah, this is a shared file. So this is the thing I created, right? So this is one thing. So now, if you click on delete, it will get deleted, but I'm not going to do it right now. So let this be. Now, let me go for the second option. The next one is add directory. So click on this, give some sort of name, new directory. Yeah, I gave it. So it's checking. Yeah, it's done. Now create. This will create a new directory in my file share. So this is nothing but a folder, right? I have told you. So this is a file. Now a folder has gotten created. So this is how you can change the data in your file share from the Azure portal. Now, let us do something different. I don't want to commit into the Azure portal. I'm not ready to log in to my Azure portal to a browser and do these sort of activities. For that, I can create something called a file share, that is a network file share drive or a network drive. So to do that, you can find something here called as Connect. So click on it, you will get some sort of things. So these are the codes which you can make use in the Windows computer, I mean Windows operating system, and this one you're going to use in the Linux based systems. So here I'm not going to code anything, because even I'm enemy for the code, because not an enemy, but sometimes I don't like coding. So here we are going to use this one to log in into this place, that is this file share, from our local computer. So for that, first I need you to copy this one, that is windows.windroid.file.code.com.windows.net/simplespace. So just copy this one, I'm pressing Ctrl C, and go to your My PC. So we have already opened it, right? So go to your My PC and click on this PC option. So when you're in this place, you can find something called Map Network Drive. So click on this. So here you can find an option called Map Network Drive. Click here. So there are two options. You can browse and choose it in the network. I'm not connected to any LAN network, so I'm not going to use this one. So I'm simply going to paste my path in here. So remember, it should be in this format. So I have did it and I'm clicking on finish. So this is attempting to connect with my one. So for this connection, what you have to do is, again, you have to go to your portal. There, this is the username, windroid.note2. This is the same thing which you gave for your storage account. So copy it and paste it. Now next one is password. To get your password, you should do something different. Here your password will not be found. So look at this one, view access key for this account. So this is the thing which you're going to act as your password. So click on this. This will load your password. So we have two keys are present. So you can make use of any one. So I'm going to make use of the key one. So you can even use the key two as your access key. It is not a problem at all. It will work. So it is copied. And again, I'm going to the same login page. So I'm giving my password. So don't try to change or don't do anything in here. Just click on OK. So this will authenticate it. And it will connect your local machine to the cloud drive, that is the storage account in there. Yeah, it's over. Now it has been created. So look at this one. Simple space. Do you remember this? We have created something called storage account in the Azure. The same thing is in here now. So let me close this. So just see. You have created something in here and I don't know what is in there. So just open it. You can see something called new directory, my file share. The same thing will be found in your storage. Let me show it. See, look at this, new directory and my file share dot text, whatever it is. So when you open this, the same thing will be found in here. Yeah, this is a shared file. So this is how you create a storage account in the Microsoft Azure and you can map it. So now, how I can do some other stuff with it? Yeah, you can do. See, if you add something in here, when adding a new folder, let it be the same. So I did it. When you go here, it has not been came. So just refresh it. My new folder is here. And if you delete something in here, so new folder is already empty, so no need of doing anything in there. So I'm clicking this one. It's getting run, so it is also empty, just don't disturb it. So this is how we do things in here. So if I delete this directory, so what I did is I just right clicked on this and I clicked on delete directory. So I'm deleting it. You are deleted. Now get in here. It is already deleted. So this is how you just upload your files right from your local machine, or you can do the same thing from the Azure portal. So this is the concept of using your file share from your local machine or from the Azure portal. Hope you like this. Hope you learned something new. In my further articles, I will be speaking about creating an Azure recovery vault, creating a gateway between two machines, creating some sort of virtual networks, and lot more. I will try to cover whatever I can in the Azure concepts. Hope you like this one. And to the final thing, so remember, coding or programming or techniques or technologies, nothing can be learned in a single day. We should spend a lot of time in learning. And even when I was learning, I was watching tutorials. At the time, I was a bit lazy and I will be feeling like, who is going to watch these videos for hours? So that is why I'm trying to cut short my videos, and I'm not at all ready to make the videos much longer. I'll try to finish things within a short span of time without making you feel lazy or get embraced by watching those videos. Hope you like this, and don't forget, ping me or mail me if you have any doubts, and find my articles in the C Sharp corner. Thank you.